Okay, good morning all. I welcome you all for today's session. In this session, we are going to discuss the chapter cooling of the plastic injection mold. The cooling of the plastic injection mold. Already we have discussed related to the different methods of the cooling used in the plastic injection mold in the yesterday's session. I think in that we have completed. Yeah, this part we have completed. There's types of the cooling channels, parallel cooling channel, series cooling channels, and multi-level cooling channel systems. These are the types of cooling channels provided to cool the mold. And after that, we have discussed these different types or different methods which we can use to cool the plastic injection mold. And depending on the part where we are providing the cooling, and through which circuit we are providing that cooling. These are the, this is the brief classification. You can see this chart on your screen. This is the brief classification of that. Okay, these are the different methods used for cooling of plastic injection mold. Already this we have completed in the previous session. Now in today's session, we are going to discuss some concepts related to the heat removal. Okay. One by one, we will discuss that. Okay, first we will start with the how to determine or how we are going to determine the heat quantity dissipated with the cooling. Okay. Now here two points are there. Simultaneously, we will discuss these two points. That is determining heat quantity dissipated with cooling when we are providing the external cooling. Okay, means here we are circulating the our cooling fluid. That is nothing but the water. We are circulating that water by providing the cooling channel in the mold halves. Okay, in the mold half, the one mold half we are providing that cooling channel. Or you can provide it in the supporting plate also that we have discussed in the previous session. And here two types of coolings will occur as we are providing some external cooling. Okay, that you can say that this is the artificial cooling which you are providing. And some cooling will occur as that mold is coming in contact with the environmental conditions. That we can say that this is the natural cooling, but natural cooling is not effective. Okay, natural cooling, you will not get that effect, or you will not get the faster cooling. Okay, first we will discuss that heat dissipation with natural cooling, and then how the actual cooling is occurring when we are providing the cooling fluid, or we are circulating the water through different channels in the mold, through the mold. Okay, for that I have added one a PDF file here. I will go through that PDF file. Okay. Wait, this part already we have completed in previous session. Okay, these are the notes of 7th chapter. I will share it in that study, update it in the study material sheet after completing this chapter. You can zoom it on your screen. Now, before discussing the concept of this, here is this concept, that is heat dissipation with the natural cooling. Okay. Now, already I have explained these terms, flowways and circuits. I think I have not discussed this ejection temperature. Okay. That concept we will discuss, and we will move towards the. Okay. Now we will discuss this ejection temperature. Okay, ejection temperature is nothing but the mold temperature. In other words, mold temperature, while the part is removed from the manufactured part, is removed, we are removing from the mold cavity. Okay, now this operating temperature or this mold temperature depends on following factors. Four factors will be there, and that four factors I have highlighted here only. The type and grade of the plastic material used. Okay, depending on the material, temperature will be different, as their melting point changes here. So this ejection temperature or operating temperature will be different. And then the length of the flow. Okay, within that means whichever shape and size you are providing for that cavity. As the shape and size of that cavity, in short, you can say that within the impression changes, it will also affect the operating temperature or ejection temperature. Then the third factor is wall thickness. Okay, this is a very important part. Whenever you are designing any plastic part, the design or deciding the wall thickness is main part, and this will affect the operating temperature also. Okay. As far as possible, you have to choose the minimum wall thickness. Okay. Then here, this parts wall thickness as well as whichever molding you are using. Okay. Molding in your total mold, depending on its wall section also. Okay. Wall thickness of the part and the wall section of the molding also. Okay. Its thickness. Whichever molding material is there, it will also affect this operating temperature and length of the feeding system. Okay, length of feed system, it is related to the injection molding only. Now, to maintain this optimum temperature, it is very important. You have to maintain the optimum temperature in the mold. And why it is necessary to maintain this optimum temperature in the mold or ejection temperature? Because it will affect the product's quality. Okay, if you are able to maintain the optimum temperature in the mold, what will happen? It will improve the cycle time. Okay, it improves the cycle time means it reduces the cooling time or it reduces the total cycle time. Okay, improves means it reduces, it does not increase. When cycle time reduces, automatically this process will become more economical and you can go for the mass production. And then second important factor here, that if you are able to control this mold temperature, or if you are able to maintain the optimum mold temperature, then it improves the quality of the product. Okay, it improves the quality of the product, and at last you will get the in short, you can say that it avoids the distortion of the product, means you will get the defect-free component, the defect-free products. So these are the means results if you maintain the optimum mold temperature. That's why you have to control that mold temperature or ejection temperature by controlling the different factors. Already we have discussed that different factors will be type of the material and its grade, then length of the feed system, then length of the flow, and wall section of the molding, and wall section of molding as well as wall section thickness of the part. Okay, in this way you can control this mold temperature. Okay, then next concept is, and this is the flowways and circuits. Already I have discussed in yesterday's session in the types of coolings of that plastic injection mold. Means water is flowing, the holes or the channels through which water will flow, water or coolant will flow, that will be termed as flowways. And system formed by that flowways will be termed as cooling circuit or simply circuit. Okay, in different cooling methods, I have shown the path. Okay, if possible, I will show you this diagram. Diagrams may be there. Yeah, okay, this is one example. Okay, this is U type cooling circuit. Okay, the path through which, path or holes or channels, these are the channels, holes or channels through which water or cooling fluid is flowing, it is termed as flowways. These are different flowways. And the complete system ओके कंप्लीट सिस्टम और ए कंप्लीट पाथ और कंबाइंड पाथ इज टर्म्ड एज द सर्किट. दिस इज द सर्किट, ओके दिस इज द फ्लो पाथ ऑफ द वर्किंग फ्लूइड और वाटर थ्रू आउट दैट कूलिंग चैनल. ओके दिस इज यू शेप्ड फ्लो पाथ, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज टर्म्ड एज यू टाइप कूलिंग सर्किट. ओके सो दिस इज फ्लोवेज एंड सर्किट्स. देन आफ्टर दिस फ्लोवेज एंड सर्किट्स we will move towards some heat dissipation with the natural cooling. Okay. Now this point is very important. Okay, in this heat dissipation will occur in two ways. Okay, natural cooling will also take place, and as we are circulating the cooling fluid or water through different cooling channels, it will also remove the heat. Okay. In this way, two types of coolings will occur. Now, why this cooling effect is very necessary here? Because the rate of solidification, yes, the rate of solidification will determine the property of the product. Okay. Depending on the rate of solidification only, properties of the product will be decided. And this rate of solidification depends on rate of cooling only. Depending on rate of cooling, rate of solidification changes, and this rate of solidification decides the properties of the final finished product. Okay, and now this solidification rate will depend on the mold plate temperature. Okay, as we are cooling that mold, temperature of that mold plate plays very important role in the solidification, rate of solidification. Okay. Now here, two types of coolings will occur. Okay, that mold will get cooled naturally and artificially also. Okay, how it is cooled naturally? As mold is open to the atmosphere, there will be some exchange or some dissipation of heat will occur with the atmosphere. That is termed as the natural cooling. Okay, that is termed as the natural cooling. And as we are circulating the water by providing the different channels, chilling effect will occur or cooling effect will also takes place, as water will remove the heat from the mold. Okay, in these two ways, heat is removed. One is the natural cooling and one is the artificial cooling. Okay, so these points just you have to highlight here, how the heat dissipation will occur in the natural cooling and how the heat dissipation will occur with the help of that means circulation of the water. Okay, these points only here mentioned in this point. Okay, already we have discussed this, that is the rate of solidification plays important role in deciding the properties of the product. Then, okay, this rate of solidification depends upon the mold plate temperature. Okay, then when the mold is open to the atmosphere, then also the circulation is this point, fourth point, please go through this fourth point. As mold is open to the atmosphere, natural cooling will occur, but that natural cooling is not sufficient. Okay, to get the desired properties, it will increase the cycle time. Okay, cooling time is increased and hence the cycle time is increased. Hence, we are providing the external cooling by circulating the water to get the effective cooling that will come in the artificial cooling. Okay, that you have to just mention here. And another point you have to highlight here, that is the whichever rate cooling effect or cooling rate is there, it depends on the thickness of the mold plate, temperature of the mold plate and thickness of the mold plate. And in the natural cooling, you have to explain that when it that mold plate comes in contact with the atmosphere, some transfer or dissipation of heat will occur. That will be termed as natural cooling. And when the water is circulated by providing different channels in the mold plate, it will come under the artificial cooling. Why we are providing this external cooling or artificial cooling? To reduce the cycle time. And as we are reducing the cycle time, the faster solidification will occur and we will get the better quality product. Okay, we will get the, or we will end up with the better quality product. That is our aim. So this part is completed here. Now how the actual heat dissipation will take place while we are circulating the water, okay, that we will discuss here. Please wait due to some power cut. Okay, electricity is not available here. Please stay there. I will try to share my screen. Wait. Please wait. I'm trying to share that file from my mobile phone. Please wait. I'm not able to connect that file here through this mobile phone. Gas electricity is not available. I'll stop this session here. And I'll conduct one session in the afternoon. Okay. Sorry for this technical issues. You can leave the session. I will conduct the session in the afternoon.
Okay, now I think this technical issue has been resolved now. Okay, I think now presentation is visible on your screen. Now we will next point. Okay, that is determining the heat quantity dissipated with the cooling. Okay, how to determine the heat quantity in the cooling of the plastic injection mold. Now, for to understand this, here it is this point that is. In case of when we are doing the cooling of the plastic injection mold, okay, when we are doing the cooling of plastic injection mold, now heat transfer as we are circulating the water or cooling fluid or a coolant by providing the cooling channels in the mold plate, okay, in the mold plate, or sometimes you can place it in the core. Cavity plate or core plate also inside that, okay, if you want to be specific. And then here, when that water is circulating, then here heat is removed, okay, heat is removed from that mold. And now this heat removal will takes place in two ways, okay, heat removal will takes place in two ways, by conduction and by convection. Okay, generally heat transfer can takes place by conduction, convection, and radiation also. But in our case, in the cooling of plastic injection mold, heat transfer occurs through two modes only. The first mode is the conduction, and second mode is convection. Okay, in these two modes, heat transfer will take place. Now, how to calculate the actual heat transfer? That is how to express it in terms of formula, and how to calculate it in the in suppose some numericals are provided, then how to calculate the exact value of the heat removed from that mold by your coolant or whichever cooling fluid you are using. By that heat removed, you have to calculate. Now here, as far as the determination of the heat quantity dissipated with the cooling is concerned, here you have to mention that generally the heat transfer occurs by three ways, conduction, convection, and radiation. But in case of cooling of the plastic injection mold, heat transfer takes place by two ways, the conduction and convection. Okay, first we will discuss the conduction. I think this is visible on your screen. You can zoom it also so that you can clearly see formulas. Transfer of heat takes place between two materials. Okay. Transfer of heat will occur between two materials which are in direct contact with each other. Okay. Which are in direct contact with each other. That will be termed as heat transfer by conduction. And this heat transfer, it will be directly proportional to the thermal conductivity. Okay, thermal conductivity of both materials, it will be directly proportional to that. And rate of heat transfer can be expressed. This Q is nothing but the rate of heat transfer can be expressed in by using this formula. It is A into K T2 minus T1 divided by L2 minus L1. This L2 minus L1 is nothing but the latent heat of fusion, difference between the latent heat of fusion. Then what is the meaning of a latent heat of fusion? Latent heat of fusion is nothing but the amount of energy required, okay, amount of energy required to change the phase of a material. Okay, to change the phase, in simple words, amount of energy required. Suppose, for example, from ice you want to convert that ice into the water, then it should absorb some energy will be absorbed by that ice, and it will get transformed to the water. That energy will be termed as latent heat of a fusion. And sometimes water will get converted into ice. During this process, heat will get released. Okay, heat may get released. When water is converting into ice, heat may get released, and that is also termed as latent heat of fusion. Means, in short, heat may be absorbed or heat may be released in In this form, clearly understand that when area of contact between the two materials, okay, this A is nothing but area of contact between two materials is more, then rate of heat transfer is also more. And if area of contact is less, then heat transfer rate is also less. Means rate of heat transfer is directly proportional to the area of contact between two materials, and it is also directly proportional to the this ratio, okay, a difference in their temperatures, difference in their temperatures and difference in their latent heat of fusion. If this ratio is more, then again heat transfer rate is more, and if this ratio is less or it decreases, then the rate of heat transfer also decreases. Okay, so this is the conduction. One example here mentioned, there's one simple example is there, a pan, if suppose one hot plate is there and one pan is placed on that hot plate, then heat will get transferred, okay, from that plate to the pan. Now this heat transfer rate will depend on the thermal conductivity of the pan and thermal conductivity of the plate. When the thermal conductivity is more, then what will happen here? The transfer rate will be more. This is the effect of this K. Okay. The K. When thermal conductivity of the materials which are in direct contact is more, then rate of heat transfer or rate of heat removal will be more. Okay. So these factors you can explain it from now only. Between their temp and then the next is the now the next mode of heat transfer here is the convection. Okay, through the convection, heat is transferred through the convection here. The transfer of heat between two materials, suppose some transfer of heat is occurring between two materials and any one of that is having some fluid motion. Okay, any one of that is having some fluid motion. Okay, here we are removing the heat from the plastic material. Injected plastic material is having higher temperature. We are going to remove the heat from that plastic material and that mold also. Okay, now as we are circulating the water or cooling coolant through that mold plate, then due to that coolant, some heat removal will take place. It will remove the heat from the mold as well as from that particular part. Okay, so this will be termed as convection. As we are removing the heat with the circulating the fluid or a coolant through the cooling channels, this heat removed will come into the convection mode. And this heat removed is given by this expression, that is Q is equal to A in K that is indexed. This is the formula, that is the heat removed by the expression. Okay, I'll explain. It is the molds are cooled mostly by the convection. Okay, generally we are cooling the mold in the plastic injection process by convection method, by circulating the water or circulating the coolant through the cooling channels. Now this heat removal during this, whenever you are circulating that coolant, this heat removal will takes place through the walls of the cavity. Whichever cavity you have provided, from that walls of the cavity, heat will be removed. Okay, that coolant will remove the heat from that particular
means you, whichever your molded part is there, from that material we are removing the heat from the when that coolant will come in contact with the wall of the cavity. Okay, the cavity it this cool of the cooling depend on these three factors. Okay, conductivity of the material, then conductivity of the plastic material which we are using for here injection process, and the coolant fluid used. Okay, on these three factors the rate of cooling depends. Okay, these points you have to highlight. That is, whenever you are doing this cooling of the plastic injection mold, heat dissipation or heat removal will occur in two ways, that is conduction and convection. And generally, the main heat removal will take place by the convection, as we are circulating the coolant or water through the cooling channels. And heat is removed from the mold as well as that your cavity or part through the walls of the cavity. Now here, what are the important factors? The conductivity of the mold material, conductivity of the plastic material, and coolant fluid used. Depending on this, the cooling rate will be decided, and depending on the cooling rate only, rate of solidification will be decided, and depending on rate of solidification, properties of the final product will be decided. Okay, so in the way you have to explain the heat dissipation combination of heat and heat cooling. Okay, so this is the conceptual explanation. Now, how to calculate the practical values by using for that? That rate he will remove is calculated by using formula. This is the rate removed from the by the cooling type for. Visible. Okay, so this is the calculation of a rate of heat removal by the cooling circuit. This is the formula, that is Q is nothing but the rate of heat removal or rate of heat transferred, rate of heat transfer from mold. From mold we are removing the heat by circulating the water, by providing the different cooling channels, and this rate of heat removal or heat transfer is denoted, or it is in kilojoules per hour. Okay, kilojoules per hour. This is the rate of heat removal. And now this rate of heat removal depends on following factors. The first factor is mass flow rate. Okay, this is a mass flow rate. Mass flow rate is nothing but mass of plastic material injected into the mold per hour, and it is indicated in kg per hour. Okay, this is kg per hour, not kilojoules per hour. Mass flow rate is it is in kg per hour. This is kg. Okay, kg per hour. Okay, this is mass flow rate. Then after the mass flow rate, specific heat of the material. Yes, okay, specific heat of the plastic material. Then difference between the temperatures. Now this temperature T1 is the temperature of the plastic material at the time of injection. Okay, ejection temperature. Ejection temperature of the material, and generally you have to take it in degree Kelvin or degree Celsius. A degree Celsius or degree Kelvin it is considered. Then T2, this is the temperature of the mold or temperature of the water supplied.
Okay, water supply temperature means its inlet temperature we have to take. Temperature of mold or water supply temperature, that is inlet temperature, and L is the latent heat of fusion of the plastic material. Latent heat of fusion or latent heat of diffusion in kilojoules per kg. That is heat, amount of heat required to change the phase. Okay, so these are the factors or rate of heat removal by the cooling circuit depends on these factors, that is mass flow rate, then specific heat of the material, then injection temperature of the material, temperature of the mold or water supply temperature, and latent heat of fusion. Depending on these factors only, you can calculate the rate of heat removed by the cooling circuit. Okay, in this point you have only write this formula and you have to explain all the parameters. Okay, then how to calculate, okay, now the next point is calculation of the weight of the water to be circulated for the cooling. Weight of the water circulated for the cooling. Now here one formula is there. Now for effective cooling, already we have discussed this. Effective cooling depends on a rate of heat removal, and the rate of heat removal will depend on the quantity of water or weight of the water circulated per hour. Okay, these two points you have to highlight here, that is effective cooling depends on the rate of heat removal, and rate of heat depends on the quantity of the water or weight of the water circulated per hour. Okay, and that is nothing but the weight of the water, and this weight of the water is calculated by using this formula. Okay, here you have to use this formula, heat removal rate. Again, this is another formula for a heat removal rate. This is Q is equal to Km in bracket T out minus T in bracket complete. Okay, now here this Q is nothing but a rate of heat removal, or a rate, you can say that amount of heat extracted, or a rate of heat extracted in kilojoules per hour. And this K is a constant for heat transfer efficiency, and this M, small m, stands for weight of water circulated per hour, okay, in kg. Weight of water circulated in kg per hour or weight of water circulated per hour in kg. Okay, both are same. Just you have to calculate this M is nothing but weight of water. Then here two temperatures are there, T out and T in. This T out is nothing but water outlet temperature, and T in is nothing but water inlet temperature. Okay, T in, inlet temperature of water, and T out, outlet temperature of the water. Yeah, it you have to take in the Kelvin or in degree Celsius. Okay, now by using this formula, rate of heat removal, this Q is represented by two equations. Okay, try to remember this. This is the one formula, rate of heat removed or rate of heat extracted is given by Q is equal to Km T out minus T in, and this rate of heat removal is also explained by this formula, that is Q is equal to M Cp T1 minus T2 plus L. Okay, these both formulas we are going to use. Okay, with the help of this, here we are going to calculate rate of heat removed. Then in numerical, they may give you all these parameters and they will ask you to calculate rate of heat removal, or sometimes they may provide you rate of heat removal and any one unknown value from these parameters. Okay, that you have to calculate, and just you have to take care of the units. Okay, is proper, take proper care. Then calculation, weight of the water is very important to get the desired cooling effect, and here also weight of water you can calculate. This is the M is the weight of water, and rate of heat removed you can calculate from the previous formula. It is M Cp T1 minus T2 plus L. By that formula you can calculate this rate of heat removed or rate of heat extracted, or directly it may be given in numerical, and that value you can use here, and you can calculate the weight of water circulated. Okay, so these are weight of water circulated, then heat removed during the cooling, and the next is the cooling time. This is the next factor, and depending on these three factors and these three four formulas, we are going to solve some six, say 5 to 6 numericals. Okay, 5 to 6 numericals will be there that we are going to solve in the afternoon session. Okay, afternoon sessions we will solve these numericals, and just now I have to complete this cooling time concept. Okay, now already lots of times I have explained this in the plastic injection molding process, the whichever cycle time is required. Okay, depending on the cycle time only you will get the your final product, means depending on a rate of solidification, and whichever cycle time, total time taken by the method to manufacture this product, 80% time is required for the cooling. Okay, now this cooling time is directly proportional, or it depends on heaviest wall thickness and thermal diffusivity. Okay, this is one formula. This cooling time depends on heaviest wall thickness and thermal diffusivity. And heaviest wall thickness square you have to take here for calculation purpose. In short, you can explain that this cooling time is directly proportional to heaviest wall thickness and inversely proportional to the thermal diffusivity. Okay, thermal diffusivity. And this thermal diffusivity is calculated, or it depends on, okay, this is the thermal diffusivity. Thermal diffusivity is directly proportional to thermal conductivity and inversely proportional to density of that material and specific heat of that material. Okay, and while for calculation purpose of thermal diffusivity you have to use this formula. Thermal diffusivity is equal to thermal conductivity raised to 1.6. its thermal conductivity is power 1.6 divided by density into specific heat. Okay, cooling time is equal to heaviest wall thickness square divided by thermal diffusivity, and this thermal diffusivity is calculated by using this formula, thermal conductivity power 1.6 or raised to 1.6 divided by density into specific heat. And again, one more formula is there to calculate the cooling time. Cooling time is directly proportional to power of 1.6 for the largest runner diameter to the thermal diffusivity. These two formulas are there. Okay, cooling time is directly proportional to the square of heaviest wall thickness, as well as it is directly proportional to the largest runner power of 1.6 for largest runner diameter, and inversely proportional to the thermal diffusivity. And this thermal diffusivity is equal to power of 1.6 for thermal conductivity and 2 the density and specific heat. Okay, means it is directly proportional to thermal conductivity and inversely proportional to density and specific heat. Okay, by using these different formulas you can calculate the cooling time. Okay, now in the next session we will try to solve different numericals. Okay, different numerical examples we will solve in the next, in the afternoon session. Okay, now in this session, which important factors which we have discussed are starting from the ejection temperature or optimum mold temperature. Why we have to maintain the optimum mold temperature or ejection temperature, which factors will affect that ejection temperature, and what will be the its effects. Then after that we have discussed flowways and cooling circuits. Then heat dissipation with the natural cooling we have completed. And then we have heat dissipation with the natural cooling. Then we have discussed the determination or determining the heat quantity removed during the cooling by conduction and convection. Okay, and how actual heat removal occurs in the cooling of plastic injection mold by convection. Okay, then rate of heat removal by cooling circuit, or heat quantity dissipated by cooling. This is nothing but this formula Q, and this rate of heat removed depends on these four factors: mass flow rate, specific heat of the material, temperature of the material injected, temperature of the mold or water supply temperature, and latent heat of fusion. Then we have determined, or we have discussed, how to calculate the weight of water to be circulated for cooling and why it is necessary, because effective cooling depends on the rate of heat removal, and a rate of heat removal depends on weight of water. And that heat removal rate or extracted rate can also be given by this formula Q is equal to Km T out minus T in. This is constant for heat transfer efficiency, that is K. M is the weight of water circulated, outlet temperature of water, that is T out, and inlet temperature of the water is T. This is amount of heat removed. This you can calculate by using previous formula, rate of heat removed or rate of heat extracted. And with help of these two equations, you can calculate the weight of water required to be circulated to get the desired cooling effect. Then cooling time. Okay, this as cooling time plays a very important role. 80% cooling process, total cycle time, cooling process. Cooling time is given by these two laws. That is, cooling time is equal to square of heat waste speed, thermal diffusivity, and another time equal to ratio of 0.6 for the diameter to thermal diffusivity. And thermal diffusivity is equal to power of 1.6 for this thermal conductivity to the density and specific heat. Okay, then different numericals depending on these five formulas are there. A rate of heat removal from the by the cooling circuit, then how to calculate the weight of water, then cooling time, two formulas for cooling time, and one formula for thermal diffusivity. In the this part is completed here, then we will solve the numericals based on this in the afternoon session. Okay, now I will stop this session here. Okay, in this session we have completed this part, that is determining the heat quantity dissipated with cooling, then heat dissipation with the natural cooling, then calculation of weight of water, and calculation of the cooling time. In the next session we will solve some numericals, and after that we will discuss points, that is temperature, thermal resistance of a mold body, and summary and dimensions of summary dimensions with construction of correct cooling in the end. So thank you for attending this session. I will stop here. In the afternoon, I will conduct another session. Okay, in that we will solve the numericals. Thank you for attending this session.